गुड मॉर्निंग एंड ग्रीटिंग्स टू ऑल डिग्निटरीज। श्री धर्मेंद्र प्रधान जी, मिनिस्टर ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड स्किल डेवलपमेंट एंड एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप। श्री रामेश्वर तेली जी, मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट फॉर पेट्रोलियम एंड नेचुरल गैस एंड लेबर एंड एम्प्लॉयमेंट। श्री महेश साहू, मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट। श्रीमती सीमा रानी नायक, मेंबर ऑफ लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली। श्री के पद्माकर, चेयरमैन एंड मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर बीपीसीएल। श्री अरुण कुमार सिंह, डायरेक्टर मार्केटिंग बीपीसीएल। इंक्रीजिंग द ऑपरेटिंग एफिशिएंसी ऑफ स्टेट ओन्ड एसेट्स इज वन ऑफ द प्राइम एजेंडास ऑफ आवर गवर्नमेंट। By optimizing shared infrastructure and leveraging economics and economies of scale, not only do CPSEs achieve lower costs and decreased redundancies, but are also better equipped to cater to the increasing demands of a growing Indian market. I am therefore very happy to be a part of the laying of foundation stone for common user facility at Sadashivpur, Dhenikal district, Odisha, which will cater to the rising demand of petroleum products in Dhenkanal district as well as the adjoining districts of Anugul, Deogarh and Keonjhar. These districts, which comprise one of the most mineral rich regions in India, are home to major steel, aluminium and thermal power producing units such as Tata Steel, Nalco, Jindal India Thermal Plant and NTPC. This ₹394 crore project, which is being led by BPCL and will be utilized by all three OMCs, will create a state-of-the-art 42,000 KL fully automated storage depot and 12-bay TLF gantry spread over 50 acres of handling, storage and supply of not only petrol, diesel, but also new age biofuels like ethanol and biodiesel. This CUF will receive petroleum products from IOCL's Paradeep Ranchi Raipur pipeline, and plans are afoot to enable receipt of product by rail as well. The facility will be able to store supply worth 20 days of petrol and 12 days of diesel as per current demand, which is crucial for a disaster cyclone prone state like Odisha. I must also commend BPCL for their efforts in the ongoing creation of India's first 2G ethanol biorefinery in Bargarh district of Odisha, with an investment of ₹1,600 crores, which will be capable of refining 100 KLPD of ethanol from rice straw feedstock. These projects underline our focus on increasing ethanol blending and petrol by 20% to 20% by April 2023. I want to highlight the fact that since 2014, ethanol procurement in India has increased by more than 800%, from 38 crore litres in 2014 to 325 crore litres in 2021, generating ₹21,000 crores, of which a significant portion has gone to Indian farmers. Today, India has innovated biofuel technology to produce ethanol from not only sugarcane and food grains, but also agricultural stubble, which often burn, causing air pollution. Bamboo, which is abundant in India's northeast region, and used vegetable oil are also being used, thereby reducing food wastage. Furthermore, MORTH will soon announce a new policy for encouraging automobile manufacturers to produce flexi-fuel engines to incentivize the consumption to ethanol blended petrol in India. CUF Sadashivpur will not only increase the ready supply of petroleum products in Dhenkanal, but also contribute towards reduction of the logistics cost of transporting petroleum products from Paradeep, the benefit of which will be ultimately passed on to the consumer. The project will provide direct and indirect employment and bring business and economic growth to the local community by generating approximately 2 lakh man-days employment during the construction period. Odisha has been one of the focal points of the petroleum sector's growth in the past 7 years, which have generated millions of man days of employment and create avenues for development of ancillary industries like plastic and petrochemicals.